Hey guys, welcome to another very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we'll be designing this logo. If we see this, you can see that this piece looking like ribbon has been revolved around an imaginary cylinder in such a way that their two ends are not covering up the whole cylinder. It has been placed over the cylinder, which covers up only the half portion of the cylinder. So let's understand this with the example. So to create this logo, we'll first draw a strip of rectangle. So let's create a strip of rectangle. Fill this with some color. Now let's convert this object into symbol. To do that, we'll go to Windows and open up the symbol palette, or you can get the small option here, and after this, just click and drag it in there. Okay, name it ribbon and click OK. With that, you have prepared your symbol. Now you can delete this. After this, the next step is we need to make a cylinder. To do that, we'll just create a rectangle of some thickness. Now go to Effect, 3D Revolve. With this option, you can create a three-dimensional object, a cylindrical three-dimensional object. So you can preview that the cylinder has been formed. You can just keep all the values zero and go to Map Art. Over there, you got your top, bottom, and the side which revolves, which is the surface over where we want to revolve our ribbon. So here you got your option to select the ribbon option. It is there. Now we have to rotate it. Just rotate it and you can see it there. If it's not visible, just ensure that it's invisible geometry, where the surface, cylindrical surface, will be invisible. So just scale it down and place this in the center in such a way that it is covering up only the half portion of the cylinder. That means it should not cover up the whole cylindrical surface. It should cover only half. So let's scale this on a little bit more and place it in the center so that these two ends are in a single line. So place it carefully, just and place it in the center. Once you get your design and once your rotation is okay, then click OK and click OK. So you got your object here. Now the next step is to convert this whole system into object. So go to Object, Expand Appearance, Object Expand. Do this for almost 2 to 3 4 times so that everything inside it can be converted, should be converted to object form. And after that, just select it and ungroup and release clipping mask. Delete the clipping masks selected and just do it one more time. Expand it so that whatever inside it should be converted into object form. Ungroup it, and now you can scale this up and your piece of ribbon is ready. The next step is we have to extend this and make sure that they're forming a straight line. So ruler, will just drag out the ruler and place it there. Now the next step is with the direct selection tool, select the vertices and click and drag it and place it over the ruler grid guidelines. Now after that, do the same thing for the lower portions also. If it's not over it, just select it and place it over the grid so that they form a straight, they are on the straight line. Click it and just place it over there and make sure that they are on the straight line. Place it there. Then after that, the next to control the handles, don't use the die selection tool because sometimes it is connected with the other handles. So with the convert anchor point tools, you can independently select the handles, and with the shift you can snap it perpendicular. So use the convert anchor point tool to do that. Select the, with the die selection tool, you can select the object, see the handles, yeah, with the direct selection, and with the convert anchor point tools. You can see the handles. Now snap it over there. Do the same thing for this handle. Select it, snap it. Now after that you can just delete this ruler and extend it a little bit more if it's looking short. To create the other piece, you can just group this, Control G, go to Reflect tool, double click on it, option will appear, keep it vertically and preview it, and copy it. The duplicate of your previous shape will be created. Now place it in the correct place. Now ungroup everything and bring this piece or into front. This will bring this piece over the front. Now the very important tips which I'm going to give here is this: to apply a gradient to this piece, you have to click the eye picker tool, and with the shift and alt click you can apply independently any gradient color over any piece. This is a very important tool. If you just select and with the eye picker tool you just select it, it is not going to function properly. So you have to just select the object, fill it with some normal color, and with the eye picker tool selected, shift and alt, you can see the T over the tool, and just select it. And with the gradient tool you can independently edit it. Now in the same way, select this with the eye picker tool, eye, shift and alt clicked, select the color, select the other piece, eye picker tool, shift and alt click, and with the mouse click you got the color. Now with the gradient tool you can just adjust the gradient colors. Select the gradient tool, adjust the gradient colors. So play with this. Now this one selected with the gradient tool, just apply it properly. Make sure that here are the dark portion for the shadows, and do it until it's okay. Now for this also select it with the gradient tool, just move it down, select this piece with the gradient tool, adjust the colors. Make sure here's the dark portion. In this way you have created the piece. You can just expand it and place it there. You can always give the finishing touch by editing the gradient colors, because sometimes if it's not looking good, you have to do it until the finishing end. Now the next step is to create the shadow. We'll just take a ellipse tool, fill it with black color, and just drag it out. Now in the effect, go stylized, blur, Gaussian blur, and blur it out. You can preview it, and okay, now you can reduce it to almost 60%. Duplicate this, Control C, Control F, scale it down a bit and place it there. Now group it, Control G, and arrange it to the back, sign it to back, and place it below. Now duplicate this by Alt and Control drag, and place it to the other corner. In this way we have created the shadow. Now the next step is to write a text. So select the text, Celcius, C-E-L-C-I-U-S, Celcius, capitalized it by just selecting it. And in the character you can just click this option and everything will be in capital. Or, and if you want to give some spacing in betweens, go to character, give some spacing, maybe 100, or you can even give bigger spacing, 200, and so you can scale this up, place it properly, give it some gray color, give it some gray color. Okay, and we have almost finished our logo. So this is how you can create this kind of logo very easily. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing and tips, you can click the subscribe button. Thank you.